So we've been talking on French sources, French notations. Some videos, some topics were very deep to cover, and we will have to do it probably sometimes again, because it's a lot of can be said on those sources. We have made a bridge a little bit with the triple meters, with the waltz tempo to Czerny's Opus 500, which is his piano school, in which he gives, in amongst other places, the third volume, a clear indication how to use the metronome. So I believe that was an interesting topic. If you haven't seen, there is a link here in the video, you can check it out. So, but before we dive into really the journey of the, not only the journey, the metronome numbers, which of course is of concern to many because it influences a lot the way we play Beethoven, Mozart, Haydn, amongst others, I would like to present you with one question, that is, if you overlook the French sources, the tempi we have from all those sources, and there are a lot in the 18th century, you go to Quantz, which is also a source for tempo indication, and then you go to the metronome numbers, early 19th century, we have thousands, if not 10,000 of them. So if you overlook all of them, is there a kind of unity amongst them, so that you can say what the people early 19th century were giving as a tempo indication actually reflects what the French notation is, what Quantz is doing? So what is your take on that?
Also, die französischen Pendelangaben beziehen sich hauptsächlich auf Tänze. Mhm. Das ist schon mal wichtig. Und dann sind eigentlich diese Vergleiche mit Aufzeichnungen von französischen Tänzen in Deutschland dann ausschlaggebend. Und da muss man sagen, schon diese 50 Jahre französische Pendelaufzeichnungen im 18. Jahrhundert zeigen ein ziemlich homogenes Bild. Mhm. Also es gibt keine großen Abweichungen bei den Tänzen wie Gavotte, Bourée, Sarabande, Passegai, Menuet, Chic. Es ist relativ kohärent.
Ja.
Ja, bleibt kohärent in diesen 50 Jahren. Dann kann man den Vergleich anstellen mit Quantz. Bei Quantz muss man natürlich davon ausgehen, seine Tempoangaben sind sehr schematisch. Mhm. Eine sehr primitive Halbierungstheorie im Grunde genommen vom Pulsschlag. Und, also das sind wirklich nur grobe, ja, grobe Einteilungen. Es ist erstaunlich, wie kohärent, ja, diese Angaben, okay, eigentlich sind. Also Quantz und die französischen Tanzangaben lassen sich mühelos vereinen. Kein Problem. Und nimmt man jetzt noch Czerny hinzu, und zwar seine Bach,
ja,
seine Suiten-Metronomisierung, ja, dann muss man sagen, eigentlich auch wieder erstaunlich. Bei Czerny ist es durchaus vergleichbar. Seine Tempi sind etwas langsamer, also metrisch gelesen, etwas langsamer als, ja, die metrisch verstandenen
Französischen. But it doesn't matter if you read it metrical or not, the numbers are the same. Yeah.
Ja, genau.
About, so there is, so because, you know why it's interesting, because I've read the remark, it was in fact a question of Justin remark, that there is no such connection between the metronome numbers and the French tradition, yeah, of double beat. Metrical time measurement.
So man kann sagen, Czernys Metronomisierung von Bach Tanzstücken, also ja, Suitensätzen, sind etwas langsamer als die französischen. Hängt natürlich auch damit zusammen, dass die Bachschen Suiten ja nicht eigentliche Tanzmusik ist, ja, also ja, stilisiert. Oder?
It's another country, it's another kind of music, but ja, it's within the range of the same. Ja. And then if you go from Czerny, then the Bach metronome numbers, and that's something that I can answer also for, that there is not such exception within the metronome numbers overall.
Ja.
So if you go to metronome numbers by Sonaten und bei Moscheles und bei Hummel, they're all in the same range. There's not such thing as the Moscheles numbers or the Czerny numbers. They're, yeah, all in the same. That's what, yeah, strikes me all the time. Yeah. And people tend to forget that, that there is not such thing as individual metronome numbers. They have all their own, but there is a kind of unity in that. So you want to say something else?
Ja, auch die Platzierung des moderaten, des mittleren Tempos, Tempo Ordinario,
also ja,
das gemäßigte Allegro oder Moderato, auch da, wenn man also jetzt Quanz metrisch versteht, dann liegt sein Tempo Moderato, Allegro Moderato auf 60, bei Türk Allegretto, also auch ein gemäßigtes ja, Allegro, auch bei 60, bei Tiemé 1801 auch bei 60 und bei Mason oder Mason, ein Engländer, das Moderato auch bei 60.
Ja, also metrisch
Menzel bei 70.
Also
auch da
ja,
haben wir eine sehr schöne.
Ja. Ja, as I understand it, the tempos and movements are speeding up towards the 18th century, continues in the 19th century, but not like this, very slightly, very gentle. We're going to cover Quanz, certainly, but for this video I think that
no,
das reicht, wie man in auf Deutsch sagt. So, thank you for staying here with us so long, because I know it's difficult, it's theoretical, it's not practical. I make some practical videos on how to apply that in music, and that's of course much more direct, but I believe it's important to cover the theory, what needs to be covered. And so if you have questions, don't hesitate to leave them in the comments below, certainly on YouTube, on Facebook. Again, it's a little bit difficult for me because my Facebook inbox box, it goes out of the sky every day, so I don't manage to have all comments replied on Facebook, but on YouTube, that's my main focus. Of course, if you want to ask something, go there and or just give your own feedback and your own experience, really interests me. Thank you for watching, for subscribing to the channel, sharing this video with your friends, and we see each other very soon again. Bye.